Data protection laws are rapidly expanding around the world. We have seen recently the General Data Protection Regulation in Europe. We've seen the California Consumer Privacy Act. We've seen other data protection laws recently developed in other American states. We've seen countries like the United Arab Emirates recently adopt data protection law. And although these laws from one jurisdiction to another can vary quite a bit, there are some big, broad, common themes. And it's useful for people and organizations that are doing business around the world to be aware of these common themes. And the common themes won't perfectly ensure that you are in compliance with California law or the law in the United Arab Emirates. However, if you're seeking to meet these common themes and comply with them, you're getting closer to compliance around the world, and therefore your overall legal liability for not complying with a particular law is diminishing. So these common principles of data protection include this. Give notice to someone before you collect their personally identifiable information. Personally identifiable information can include not only their name and their passport number, but even other identifying information like geolocation data. And if you're going to give someone notice that you're collecting information about them, you should be very careful how you state the notice, that it's accurate, because you don't want any allegation that you have deceived someone about what information you have collected about them. Another common principle of data protection is data minimization. And that means you minimize the amount of data that you collect. You only collect what you need, you only store what you need. And therefore, if you are hacked, then you're not exposing as much data because you had minimized what you were storing at the time of the hack. Then, as you're processing data, you want to ensure that you're only using the data for the purpose that it was originally intended to be collected for and that you originally gave notice for. If you're trying to give notice to say, I'm collecting the data for this purpose, I'm going to process it this way, and you stay within that purpose, then your legal risk for data compliance and legal compliance around the world is diminishing. Another step of general data protection compliance is to be able to account for the data, identify what data we collect, where we store it, where we process it, and ultimately how we destroy it. Destroying the data is a good step for helping to show the authorities around the world, I'm trying to do the right things with respect to data. I use personally identifiable information, but I use it only as intended, only as necessary. When I don't need it any further, then I destroy the data. Another example of a general principle of data protection is to give notice to data subjects if their data have been compromised. So we see under the General Data Protection Regulation in Europe, a relatively new requirement throughout Europe to give notice in the event of a breach. Another important principle of data protection law is to limit the sharing of data. Limit to whom you give the data. A data broker, for example, you wouldn't want to give it to them without appropriate authority and appropriate notice for sharing that data. Now, I've spent a little time here introducing general principles of data protection around the world, but you should recognize that data protection law often acknowledges that these principles I've identified have to be balanced against other social interests. So an example of another social interest is I have a principle of limiting to whom I give data, to whom I share data. But then along comes the government, and the government gives me a subpoena demanding that I turn over the data. Well, that government subpoena may well outweigh my general principle of not sharing data. Another example of a general social principle outweighing the general principle of data protection is I may need to keep data for a longer period of time just to show in law that I'm complying with other laws, rules, and regulations, laws and rules and regulation that don't relate to data protection, but maybe I need to keep records of consumer protection law compliance. Thus, I may need to keep a record of what I did with a consumer for longer than I otherwise would have needed just for operational purposes. I teach a 5-day course at the SANS Institute. The name of that course is Legal 523, The Law of Data Security and Investigations. You can learn more about that at sans.org. You can also learn more about me and my practice of law at benjaminwright.us. Here in this video, I've given some ideas that can help to address legal compliance or legal risk. Obviously, through this video, I'm not your lawyer, and if you need legal advice, you need to go hire a lawyer to give you specific legal advice. This video is only for public education.